Hey, what's up guys, this is here, and welcome back to the next installment of my Dwarven campaign for Total War Warhammer. I hope everyone is having a wonderful day, and I'm super excited to start the next part of this campaign. So last episode, we unfortunately lost Blackfyre Pass, but Everwatcher was too strong for us, and he unfortunately made our Dwarven Lord's tomb over here. He fought bravely, however, he just was not strong enough to go ahead and hold back the tides of two Chaos Armies, two really elite Chaos Armies, might I add. They had Giants, they had Trolls, they had Hell Cannons, they had Chariots, they had Chaos Knights. All their infantry were pretty much chosen, they had Chaos Spawn. A really, really high tier Chaos Army, which is really good to see, because it means it's going to be a bit more difficult than me just fighting crappy Marauders or stuff like that. But it also means we have to maybe send a bit of a stronger force than we're used to. A lot more Longbeards with great weapons, because we need that armor piercing against the enemy units. Also, you guys let me know that I can't even send my Great Engineer up here. Or my Master Engineer, not my Great Engineer. I can't send him up here to complete the quest because you need to send a Thane or a Runesmith, which I thought was kind of dumb, you know? Why isn't a Great Engineer on the same level as them two? I don't know, maybe it's because he's just like normally in the workshop working, whereas Thanes and that Runesmiths are kind of out in the world, I don't know. But it still kind of seems a bit silly to me, but that's just part of the game, I guess. Really, as well, all we're doing is just leveling up our troops, rebuilding our armies. You can see Ungrim Iron Fist is currently getting two organ guns in his army, a unit of Iron Drakes with torpedoes. He's also going to get another couple units of Iron Breakers as well. I think we're going to put two more Iron Breakers into Ungrim's army. And that should make his troops absolutely insane. Or maybe just one more Iron Breaker unit. Yeah, just one more Iron Breaker unit, and then we'll stick our Thane back in as well, because I like having the two heroes set up in my armies. For sure, and we'll probably do the same as well with Bjorn. We'll put some more Iron Breakers in there. I don't want to flood my armies because I still like having a lot of money. Iron Breakers cost me like 300 gold per unit, I believe it is, to upkeep. So I still very much enjoy having the added income just to keep building my war chest. Just whilst we're currently at war with the enemy with the Chaos. And honestly, I can make do with not having Iron Breakers. Like, I could probably win every battle just with Longbeards, if I'm honest. So it's more about just having the cool factor of actually having just an entire army of Iron Breakers. Like, I could do it, but I'm just, you know, there's just no need to do it. It's just overkill, really. That would just slaughter everything. Maybe after we're kind of once we've taken back all the mountains, maybe when we go into the Chaos Waste, I'll send an entire army of Iron Breakers. Which, oh my god, that'd be insane. Actually, I don't know. Maybe I should just build, like, a load of Iron Breakers and just for the lols and just see how far I can get. Because that would be like a royal army, just an entire army of Iron Breakers. Let me know in the comments down below if you think it's a good idea, or if you just want to see it because you think it'd be really cool if I just stick all the Iron Breakers in Ungrim's army and he just moves northwards. God, this agent keeps assaulting me. It's really annoying. We can give them fire. What is this? The Signar comes to pleading to us once again. They have witnessed our devastating flame weapons and beg that we share them. Our secrets. We can give it to them, or this will remain our intellectual property. Screw the Empire. I'm not going to give them some valuable technology. What have the Empire ever done with us? I'm going to try and assassinate him again. Oh, we succeeded as well, and we cleared a grudge. That's actually really good. I'm happy that happened. Shoulder axes, lads. Cazador can chill in Varrak Hills. Bjorn is what is he? What was I doing with Bjorn? Building Thunderers? I can't even remember what I was even doing with Bjorn. And he also leveled up as well, which is good. We will start boosting up his Grimnir's Air ability, which is just so good, making Longbeards, Hammerers, just every unit he pretty much has, just really, really good. I think I might actually get rid of some of these Quarrelers. Actually, no, because these are famous. These are just Quarrelers anyway, so I'm not even getting rid of any named units. And we'll build some Thunderers. I think one more unit of Thunderers. And then what do we want? Do we want, like, another... Do we want some Iron Drakes? I feel like Iron Drakes are just cool. So let's go ahead and pick up another unit of these guys. It will take a while for this to be done, but... That's fine. Thorgrim is slowly making his way home. He's been away in the Badlands for a long, long time. A long, long time. Let's just go ahead and just build some more Iron Breakers. Yeah, they cost me 400 gold. Let's just screw it. Let's just build an entire army. Fuck it. Like, I'm just going to do it. These guys can all move out, like these 4 dozen blades, all these brave warriors, Ungrim's Wolves can move into someone else's army, and we're just gonna deck this army out. This army is gonna take back our Dwarven holds. Ooh, and that's interesting, we're actually starting to lose them to the Chaos tribes as well, the huge Chaos tribe up there to the north. That's cool. I might consolidate with this faction as well. Like, I might do it because they have gold here and stuff, and it's really valuable, and I want these mountain provinces anyway. So I might just consolidate with them. But I'll do that when Ungrim is ready to move northwards. I guess that's the best thing to do is to wait. Oh, these guys are actually suffering attrition. Oh, my bad. I didn't even notice that. So, by the looks of it, the Chaos armies are marching to the vampires now. Now we've taken out Karak 8 Peaks, they're marching towards... Not Karak 8 Peaks, sorry. Taking out Blackfyre Pass, they're now marching towards there, which is fair enough. Tilesia are chilling. I'm surprised the Tilesian army's all the way up here. But oh well, like, I imagine my army is just going to get killed, because it's kind of out by itself. There's a Vampiric army as well running away. But shout out to Karak Kadrim for taking back the northern province, because the vampires have held that province for a long time, so that's very good that they're actually doing something. It means when I consolidate with them, which I think I'm definitely going to consolidate with them, just because I want them three provinces. The reason I didn't do it before was because I'd just taken pretty much all the provinces down to the south, and I didn't want to have -8 public order. But public order really isn't an issue right now. I have a huge amount of it. I think all my provinces are pretty much at 100. We can actually look at it if you guys are interested. What is it, tab? And when we go public order. Yeah, everywhere is happy apart from Death's Pass, which is actually still unhappy. And this province, which was assaulted by the Bjornling invasion. But now we don't have to worry about that. Because, yeah, they're slowly getting happy. So I'll wait a few more turns probably before I consolidate. And I probably need to sort out the unhappiness in Death's Pass. Because that's the least... Oh, yeah, I definitely do not want a rebellion. I can do this. This will probably help out with some military presence. Yeah, that boosts up the happiness a little bit. And we can also increase this province, which we will do. And then we can improve the feast hall. Over here, how happy are you guys? Relatively. We'll go ahead. What's more important? Our port city is probably more important. So let's upgrade that. And then we'll also... Oh my god, look at the Iron Breakers being built. That is just draining my economy. So I want to have a military post here. Because I want to be able to at least build some troops. And then we still have just a spare slot, which I don't... I mean, I guess we could build an armory. And then we can get Longbeards down here. Because eventually there will be some uprisings of Savage Orcs. And I want Dailed of the Durable to be able to take them out, so... Yeah, nice. One more turn. Oh, no, he's actually done now. Cool, let's move him up. We have 4 units. Oh, my God, that literally rinsed my economy so badly. And then we're getting another 3 as well. Damn, this army is going to be so lit. This is going to be so good. My economy is going to be in the shitter, but it's going to be so cool just seeing. And Ungrim will have a heavily armist army to take back the Mountain Halls. He has organ gunners. He has a cannon to take out large and heavily armored units. He has slayers. He has Iron Drake torpedoes. The only thing he's missing is gyrocopters. But gyrocopters really aren't that great in the game, which is unfortunate. And we'll definitely stick back our Fane as well. Magnus has been beside Ungrim for a long time now. So yeah, we can fit in 5 more Iron Breakers. And we're getting... Yeah, we have 5 and then 2 for this army for Bjorn or Byron. Nice. And then he's going to march northwards. He's just going to fight everything in his way. And as well as that, Thorgrim finally makes it home after a long, long journey to the south. They actually lost. They tried to take one of the Karaks, and they lost. Sucks to be the vampires, really. I mean, as soon as we move our army northwards, we can just, yeah, completely dominate the area. We're going to start off by taking back Zufbar, I think. Then having a stationary garrison there. Like, I will actually have an actual garrison there. Friends of the Dowie. Oh, Talia, not Talicia. I've been slaughtering this name. Sorry if you guys have been annoyed at me. I'm obviously not going to join against my dwarven brethren. Why would I do that? Talia, sorry, not Talicia. It's just because I've been playing a bit of The Witcher 3 and The Witcher 2 recently. So I'm just, used to their type of names. Because Talicia is a very Witcher 3 sounding name. That's probably why I got it in my head, but Talia. The Empire have been destroyed. Safeguard, yeah, we have to take Safeguard. One, we don't need the money, and two, the Vampiric Corruption is amazing. So we'll definitely take that to reduce it all. Because, like, look here, we're like minus, we're like 20% here, which is really not bad for this time in the campaign. I guess you just move here, but I don't really have a need for this army right now. I guess Thorgrim can just chill. He'll move back to his hall because he hasn't even seen his throne room yet. He's been away since I've built the throne hall of the High King. He hasn't even been here. Oh, here we go. So all these Longbeards come back and all these guys go up. Yeah, has that worked now? Damn. And we still have a space for one more, yeah? Should we get another unit of hammerers, or do you think two hammerers is enough? Because look at this battle line right now. This is formidable. We don't really have much range, but what we lack in range, we make up with our artillery, the slayers, hammerers, and ironbreakers. I think we get another unit of ironbreakers just because I want to have a longer, more effective line. I literally think that we are unstoppable right now. I don't think there's a single army the AI can muster. I don't think it's multiple armies the AI can muster to defeat this army. So yeah, let's march our way. We're making our way to the mountains now. You can go back for now. You've actually got a pretty large army of Longbeards as well. I might stick a few of these Longbeards into Thorgrim's army, maybe. But yeah, look at our economy now. Our economy is definitely in the shitter. And all our armies are kind of in one area. This is pretty much our military force, minus the few troops we have laying around. We have our five armies there, and we have another army down here, which is here to safeguard against any enemy forces. So I guess, I mean, I don't really just want to get Longbeards here, or like dwarf. I mean, we'll get a few Dwarven Warriors. We'll get like three, and then I guess we will focus on getting some more elite troops there. But we have to start being a bit careful with our economy because we're not making it as much money. We're making probably half as much money as we were. I will send an army as well. I guess Bjorn will go back and retake. Or maybe Thorgrim's quest will go back and reclaim Blackfyre Pass because we can just re-inhabit it. Obviously, it means we'll lose soldiers to re-inhabiting it, and they'll go off and start making families and repairing their lands and stuff. So we'll kind of have a weakened army, but as long as there's no mass troops around, that's fine with me. I just really want to see where the Everwatcher goes, like if he's gonna just carry on just destroying the vampires or what. Because I can't actually see him right now. I guess maybe sending my engineer just to scout them would have been a good idea. Yeah. And we can activate him in here. He's not really doing a hell of a lot, but he is reducing the ammunition of the hell cannons by 30%. So that might be able to help out Talia. There are a few captains there. The agents, the amount of agents that the vampire lords have. Level 14. I mean, we can deal with all of these apart from a level 14. Keep on marching. So can you tunnel anywhere important? You can tunnel there, or you can march here. So let's march you here. Look at this army. Wow. Seven units of Ironbreakers, two hammerers for the flanks, two slayers. We've got torpedoes, organ guns. Damn. I'm so excited to just use that army in battle. I mean, even this army was like a leftover army, and it's still just as good. I need this army so that, yeah, I need this army so I can move the missiles into it. Because I don't want to get rid of the missiles just because look how good they are. But I need, different troops. I need to, reformat the army, so Cazador can kind of be, the waiting room for all my armies. And everywhere is super happy right now. This place obviously just became unhappy, but we should sort it out very, very soon. All these buildings are going to be built. We have a dockyard building, garrison post, so we'll have walls in every settlement down here. So if any Savage Orcs do come, they'll be in for a shock. We're rebuilding this so we can hopefully make it a bit more happy, but it's slowly becoming happy anyway. And the Chaos Corruption is also on the down low, so things are going pretty good. And we also have Iron Price being built, which is kind of funny because we've just built all our Iron Breakers and Iron Drakes. However, it will move us on to better technology. Iron Breakers, more armor and melee defense, that would be good. That's just amazing. Leadership for Hammerers, they just never break. Iron Veterans, this is what I want to work towards. Scar Duty, minus 5% upkeep for pretty much every unit I'm using. So we definitely want to work towards that when we can. I also want to be moving an army northwards because I really want to fight a battle this episode. But I'm not sure if I'm going to because it's already been... We're 15 minutes in, so we could. It depends just how quickly we get to Zufbar. Honestly, it'd be kind of cool if we could... Oh, yeah, they wrecked that army. Oh, they just went and siege that as well. My Dwarven Brethren, my Dwarven Dowie to the west are also starting to suffer the Chaos Corruption. Where are Bretonnian's armies? There they are, right there. Jesus, they have like 9 armies there. Oh, also, I started streaming recently. I streamed the other day. I did some Mountain Blade action, which was a lot of fun. I do definitely want to do like a streamable Warhammer campaign where like donations and just like loyal people can just get their names as that on the stream and stuff, and we can just have a cool time and chill out and stuff. So yeah, make sure that I'll put my Twitch link in the description, so make sure to go over there and follow me. This army can move back and just continue to keep this province happy until we can upgrade to the Mead Hall. Why are they so unhappy out of interest? Difficult, oh, just corruption. Do they have like a huge amount of corruption? Not really. No more than anywhere else. That's kind of weird. I guess they have a lot less happiness buildings or something. That must be the case. Someone leveled up. Nice. Magnus is now level 13, which is good. We need him to be able to just wipe out the enemy forces. More casualties. I think we changed to tunneling now. Oh no, tunneling's not even helping us. Yes. We can make it pretty far. Yeah, it'll take us a couple turns to get up here. These mountain passes are very slow. Peter von Karstein as well is just out by himself. He has nowhere to go. Another province has fallen. I want to see how big Varga are as well. How like elite their armies are. Because we haven't seen any of them for a long time. Well, we haven't seen them at all, actually. Because they've kind of been up in the north. The Chaos have been ones really ahead of this horde, of this faction. Just causing mayhem. So we haven't actually really seen the Varg yet. And I'm excited to see what they're made of. How they come up against my elite army of Ironbreakers. Oh, that's going to be so sick. You can tell the excitement in my voice just how excited I am for them. But I mean, honestly, Bjorn is ready to move. So let's go ahead and start advancing him to the front. He will go back to Backfire Pass. I'll probably use Forgrim's. I mean, Forgrim's army is really small, but that's actually kind of convenient. Yeah, I'm going to use Forgrim's army to repopulate the Black province of Blackfire Pass. Because with repopulation, it take like the more units to have, the less men it take. The more men it takes, the less men you have. But it's like over a small bunch of units, and I want to keep Bjorn's army up to full strength, so he can actually fight the Everwatcher. Because I think they're actually moving into Blackfire Pass as well. That's interesting. I mean, Bjorn's going to go there and encamp, I think, and he'll just hold the pass, because they can't go underground like we can. What do you want, Talia? Military access? Yeah. Oh, yeah, sure. I will give it to you. We are allies. I'm just not fighting my Dwarven brethren. Kind of ridiculous that I even thought I would. Even though I've never really treated with my Dawi. Oh, there they are. Oh, my God. They have like 4 armies. Jesus, that's crazy. I don't think we'll be able to get to like here. We'll be able to hold the pass, but that's about it. We can ambush. we could definitely ambush. Should we? Should we ambush? Hidden units discovered or battle initiated. Yeah, let's ambush. Why the hell not? Bjorn will set. It's not really a very common thing for the dwarves to happen. But yeah, if they want to make their way down here. And what I'll do is I'll stick Forgrim right here looking nice and juicy. In march mode as well, which I didn't mean to do. So his men are actually going to be tired. So they'll be like, yeah, sure, let's go. We're just going to go wreck them. And then all of a sudden, bang. Can we do anything annoying? We can sabotage to reduce their campaign movement. I don't really want to do that. Oh, what I could do is I could sabotage the Everwatchers so this army comes down. Oh, we failed, unfortunately. But it would have been a good plan. Nice, we actually set up a pretty cool ambush there. Ungrim, keep going. You are needed in the north because these Varg armies, level 12, level 14, level 1. So not actually that amazing, but it's just the sheer massive armies they've got built up in a small space. It's pretty scary. And they probably have a lot of armies in the center as well. They actually have some cool armies as well. I'm probably going to wait until this province is taken by the Varg before I confederate. Just because I don't want to have to fight all these armies with some of these like crappy AI-built armies. I want Ungrim to be the spearhead or the shield. I guess more of a shield just holding back the tide. Because I think it's going to look awesome. When they charge us, like their entire army is just bearing down on my forces. Hopefully in the underground. Did we ambush or what? Oh, I mean, we've got an epic battle. We've got Forgrim. We've got Bjorn fighting side by side against the Everwatcher. I mean, this army is amazing. The first army, like, the Everwatcher's army has just been depleted and he hasn't really had a chance to do anything. He's almost dead as well. Our cannons should rip through him. However, this army is really nice. Look at all these Chosens. Every one of their infantry units is a Chosen. Chosen Halberds. Chosen Warrior. What's the difference between Chosen Warrior? Oh, no, that's just Chaos Warrior. It's early in the morning, okay, guys? It's like 8 o'clock in the morning. Bear with me. This unit has a charge bonus on the halberds. Great weapon chosen. That's a really nice Chaos army. We have this Ancestral Rune to make a unit unbreakable. I guess we'll stick it on a unit of hammerers. This unit of hammerers will be unbreakable. We also have another unbreakable unit. I guess we'll stick it on the longbeards. Nice. What's the battlefield? Are we fighting in Blackfyre Pass? Hopefully we have the hill. Hopefully we have the high ground. They actually have the high ground, but they attacked us, so. Cool, let's fight this battle then. Nice, I'm looking forward to this. The enemy army is very, very good. Like, very good. But I guess we have the bonus of them actually having to come off their hill. I wish we had that hill. But that's fine. That is absolutely fine. I'm happy to fight this battle. Because both of the generals are kind of low and we can abuse that. We have nice range artillery. We have the torpedoes to take out any large creatures that come our way. Unfortunately, I don't think the I guess the torpedoes won't be bad. Because the torpedoes are just anti-armor, right? So even if they shoot into chaos units, they should do damage. We have the thunderers to deal with the chariots. Our cannons can focus down. They only really have the chariots. They don't actually have any like heavy melee engagement cavalry. The like marauder cavalry they have are more of like a skirmish cavalry. So unfortunately, I doubt you guys will see the Ungrim Ironbreaker army force anytime like in this episode. But next episode, I think we'll be having an epic battle against the Varg. I'm always tempted just to test out how many armies you can defeat and just let all four of their armies attack Ungrim and just have an absolutely crazy battle. Like, get in the underways and just let all four of them crash against my shields. I think I'm going to do that. Even if we lose the entire army, I think it will still be epic. No. What are you doing? Why? You're behind me. Oh my god, Forgrim's gonna die. We have to advance then. We have to advance to save him. Like, why are you coming on there? We have to advance up the hill. This is gonna be brutal. But I have no option. I have to do it. That sucks so much. There's actually like a chaos mark here as well, by the looks of it. Oh my god, that actually sucks so much. Because I don't think our cannons will even be doing, like, okay against the enemy force as well. Bjorn, you have to rush to try and save your king. Yeah, we just have to run pretty much and just hope. We have some can. Oh, yeah, our Iron Drakes as well. Let's see what our Iron Drakes actually look like. Because we haven't actually seen them in this campaign yet. Obviously, you guys would have seen them before previously. Very, very nice. We have torpedoes. I'll be focusing down all the heavily armored units. Are they just. So, anti large and armor piercing. So, I guess they'd still do damage because they're armor piercing against just Chaos Chosen. And then the Thunderers. I'll just stick all my Thunderers on this left flank. That actually sucks so much. I think the enemy, the AI actually decided to do this like tactically as well. I think this was an actual, the AI meant for this to happen, to split our army in half. Because if you saw them, they moved around the army. The ambush didn't kick off. I mean, luckily the enemy is actually advancing me. So all our cannons focus down that. The Iron Breakers should get ready to throw their satchels. They should come out of the mountain. Come on, throw your explosives. Oh god, the chariots are gonna crash through my line. Look, oh my lord. Let's slow it down as well because I don't want to miss any of these epic charges. Here we go. The torpedoes are coming in, actually hitting quite a few of my own men, so I should probably tell them to shoot something else. Shoot that for now. What about over here? Over here, we're just clashing straight away with the Everwatcher. He's almost dead, though. Everyone just kill him. We can slaughter him here. Boost that. You have your abilities coming in. Soon we have Stand Your Ground. Yeah, we're going to kill the Everwatcher very soon. These guys are armor-piercing and they're unbreakable. The guns can get back if they can make it. The rest of the line is clashed now as well. Let's get ready just to hold the line. The rest of the line is just holding. If we watch it. Obviously, their cavalry is going to crash into my artillery, but I don't really have anything to send. These chariots are just causing mayhem through my lines. Really just opening up for the charge of the Chaos Warriors. Where is Bjorn himself? He needs to get involved in this engagement ASAP. We need to start using his forces to run at the enemy. I don't want the Slayers to be engaging over here. I want the Slayers to get out and be nice and fresh. Troll torpedoes, keep shooting that. Keep shooting that. Nice. Sorry, I'm playing in slow-mo. I know a load of you guys don't really like love it when I play in slow-mo. I'm just making sure that I'm getting all my stuff done before we can just watch the battle. This should be an explosive ring. Yep. Oh my god, I actually killed so many more of my own men instead. Oh, this is just not my day. We'll pop our oversteel. We'll burn some people as well. We've got the hammers coming in. What are these guys doing? Just fight. Why are you running away, you cowards? The chariots are a problem right now. Yeah, we killed the Everwatcher though. Lovely. We got more reinforcements. So I'm going to send these longbeards just straight down here to reinforce the rest of our army. Because we should be making quick work of this now. As these guys are just pushing on the rest of the enemy forces. We have a Fane over here as well. We'll stand our ground as well, giving all these guys just an immense buff to everything they have. Cannons are actually still shooting. Going to be a cavalry charge here by the Marauders. The Slayers will counter charge. Because they're brave. A lot of them losing their lives, so unfortunately. And let's go back. Everyone is pretty much committed now. We can watch this fight unfold. It's actually lagging a bit. Wow. I really need to mess up. Because it's not my computer. It's my recording settings. I've been having a real bad time of it at the moment. Because it's like fine now. Like it's not lagging at all now. But yeah, I've been having a real bad time of like sorting out my recording settings. And I really just need to kind of just get it sorted. Because it should not be lagging on like high graphics. So I do apologize if this does kill any of the immersion for you guys. It's really not my my intention to do so. But this looks like, just look at this battlefield right now. The cannons are pretty much overrun. Hopefully the enemy general though is almost slain. We have another army come crushing in. make sure you deal with this hell cannon. We do not want this hell cannon ripping through. The High King is advancing. Make way for the king for sure, yeah. Make way. Nice, we managed to stop the hell cannon from shooting. We just need to clear up, because I've got so many men committed in this engagement over here. Yeah, see, it's like not lagging here anymore. The trolls clashing in, but they've even got some of the chaos spawn, is that? Bjorn's really low. He needs to be very careful. Pop your potion, because it replenishes your HP. I mean, I know you are surrounded by some great weapon. Oh, yeah, I guess you are surrounded. And they are cutting through my line on the right. We need to send reinforcements. Don't really want to use this. We can use it like this, right? Yeah, that's perfect. Burning through this line. Bring back the Iron Drakes. Yeah, this is, they're doing very good against my units. I guess because they've got a lot of armor piercing. It's to be expected. Where's our Great Engineer as well? We want our Great Engineer back to sniping the enemy forces. I guess the Slayers, yeah, our entire right flank has just been crushed. Bjorn just gets out of here. We need Bjorn to, like, fall back until reinforcements can come from over here. We just have chariots as well, just causing mayhem in my ranks. Just brace yourself. Oh, the chariots! I need a better missile force, I think, to really, really deal with this. Just keep on pushing. This death ball tactic just isn't working of mine. I thought I'd just easily be able to wipe through them, but the Chaos Chosen are just nothing we've really experienced before. Even the Iron Breakers are struggling. Where are you, Bjorn? You're over here. You just need to run. You need to get out of there, man. Keep on fighting. If we can kill their general, then victory might be ours. Keep on popping this oath as well, helping us out. Nice. We've almost dealt with this chariot. As soon as we kill the chariots, it will be GG. That's really what's causing me the issue, just the sheer amount of hammer and anvil strikes they have. We just need more infantry over here ASAP. Bjorn's actually close to routing as well. What are you doing, dude? Don't rout. Like, you're fine. We've got this battle for sure. Even though your army's, like, depleted, we still have this battle. Reinforcements are on the way. Like, there's nothing to worry about. I just want him to survive, so I'm bringing him out. Don't run, Bjorn. You're better than this. Come on. This chariot. I know I should have been bracing for that chariot charge, but it's fine. Don't rout. Why is the runesmith routing? His army's fine. Like, he's still got the entire army left. That's fine. Thorgrim can still win this battle. It's just been a lot messier than I would have liked it to have been. Like, these units should not be routing. I am very disappointed in these warriors. We've pretty much killed all the chariots now, which is what we wanted to do. Their general is kind of low as well. Now, where did Bjorn route when the runesmith is just chilling still? Our lines have formed up now over here. We've got some iron wardens holding the line. Have you pretty much won, Thorgrim? Like, I have not played this battle tactically whatsoever. So if you were looking for mad tactics, this was not a place to find. I've just been having a lot of fun, really. Trying to kill their men in a stupid death ball. Now we've dealt with them, though, we can reform up on the hill, ready to fight any advancing troops which remain. Oh, the runes. I can't believe they routed. The Iron Breakers are back, which is fine. Just keep on shooting them. The Troll Torpedoes have done a good job. Like, they haven't actually routed very much. Like, I think they've routed maybe once. And remember, this is, like, the most elite army. Like, once we defeat this, the Chaos threat is pretty much done. Oh, please come down. Please, please come down. I have nothing to really shoot you, but please just come down and I'll swarm you and you'll be dead within the second. And you did. Nice. Cool. Everyone swarm him. Kill their general. Thinking you can defeat the glorious king. Stand your ground so all these guys just get a huge buff. Obviously, he can just fly off, but as long as we surround him, we have multiple people hitting him. And if we kill their general, that should claim victory for us, I'm hoping. The chariots are pretty much all dealt with, which was my real issue. Yeah, now he's surrounded. Cool, cool, cool. Everyone just use all your special abilities to wipe him out. They have more cavalry coming, though, and a lot more infantry we have to be very cautious of. We'll turn some of his infantry to deal with them. But yeah, look how quickly their general's dying. He's used his Hellfire Sword, giving him armor piercing. But I honestly don't think it's going to be enough. We have our generals both on full strength. Look how many of the dudes he just sent flying. That was brutal. And we'll get some nice close-ups of this. I mean, he'll be dead soon, don't you worry. We have Thorgrim in the background there, fighting bravely. The chariot's coming in. I mean, I probably shouldn't be zoomed in when this battle's actually really close, but I feel like we've got this. They've got plenty of men pouring in, but the general's about to die. Once we kill the general, it's just the chance of trying to kill everyone else, really. Is he trying to get out? No, kill him. Oh my god, if we don't kill him, we're probably going to lose this battle. That is not good for us, because I don't think we're going to be able to win this battle now. I think we've literally just lost the battle. No, I actually have to. I thought this death ball was just going to work, but my poor tactics have really come back and bit me in the butt. Kill the chariots. If we kill the chariots, we're in a much better situation. Please jump down again so I can kill you. You need to get back so you can buff. Cool. Everyone kill him. Everyone just turn. You guys can focus fighting these guys. The guys actually on the front lines can continue to fight the enemy force, but everyone else, I need to get back here so I can pop stand your ground as well. To boost everyone's morale. Come on, Thane. You have to kill him. Gorrick Blackforge, your destiny is to kill him. Thorgrim charged in as well. He's so low. Just finish him off, please. If we can, even if we just rout him, I'd be happy. We've killed the Everwatch of this battle as well. Nice. Some more Longbeards to send back to the fight. Oh my god, he's running away again, the coward. And our infantry are getting so close to routing. Hold your line, Longbeards. Hold your line. I honestly thought my front line was just strong enough just to hold it, but I guess not. Where's their general? Did their general route? Yeah, we've routed the general. Okay, cool. So that's phase one of claiming back this battle. Phase two is just to keep on the pressure. Thorgrim has to get actually in their faces. He has to be fighting here. These dudes have to come back as well. How's their morale looking? They're exhausted, but so are we. We're not going to win a strap engagement, I don't think. But our heroes might claim victory for us. If they don't rout, that is. Nice, we're routing a bunch of their soldiers over here. I mean, you guys have to charge now. I should have just run you away, though. Kill the chariots. You guys get around the side. Stand your ground very soon, which is going to be so valuable. This is a super close battle. Sorry, I'm not really watching much of it unfold either. I'm just really focused on trying to win. Oh, these chariots are going to be so painful. It's really been the chariots which have hurt us this battle. Oh, they're going to rout. Fuck, I played this battle so badly. I apologize. You guys must be cringing at how poorly I played this battle. But I guess this is like what kind of happens when you've just been shit stomping everyone for the entire series. Like, you just kind of get to a point where you kind of just expect that you can't lose a battle like this, and we did lose it, which really sucked. Like, I could have easily have won that battle. I just wasn't really paying much attention and just kind of half-assing it instead of really try-harding. Fuck, that sucks. But oh well, like, we lose battles. Like, that just happens sometimes. We definitely caused a massive blow. I think we killed both their leaders. We killed the Everwatcher. I mean, we lost a lot of good dwarfs there. We lost a lot of good dwarfs. But again, like, as I said, I wasn't tryharding it. I was kind of half-assing it, and I paid the complete consequence of that. That was completely my fault. Really, really was my fault. What I should have done is I should have sent a lot of men from Thorgrim's army over to help Bjorn out. And again, Bjorn's army really isn't that strong compared to like an army like Ungrim's, you know. It's not really a chaos defeating army. And I didn't use my Thunderers whatsoever. They just got charged instantly. You know, I definitely pay that battle wrong. But I hope you guys don't mind that, you know. It's all more about the journey of how we got to our victory. And it's always interesting when we lose battles and stuff. And even if I did play it badly, I know what I did wrong and stuff like that. So, you know, in the next episode, I will be doing a lot more tryhardy stuff to actually win the battle. Close defeat, yes. But we did defeat the Lords, right? Yeah, we managed to actually, kill the Everwatcher. He is now dead. Which is good. Oh, did Bjorn die? Oh, Bjorn actually died. Fuck, that was all my fault as well. That really was all my fault. That is super sad. My bad. And they're going to advance and actually wipe out Bjorn's army as well. With all their heroes as well. I mean, we're actually going to win this battle. Which is kind of funny. And actually wiping it as well. That's so funny. Cheers, Border Prince, for coming to my rescue. We're going to kill all the captives. So, I guess the end result, overall, it was kind of a mixed bag. We lost Bjorn, which is just so sad. So, I'll look up another name for one of Ragnar's sons or something. Someone else to take the lordship of Barakvar. Friends of the Dowie. No, I don't want to join against my Dwarven Dowie brothers. So, we pretty much killed the immediate Chaos threat. The only person we haven't defeated yet. I guess there is... Sun Eater, and there's also Archeon we still need to defeat. Ambush foiled. Yeah, they foiled our ambush and really, like, ambushed us. So they managed to get in between us. But Doomtide, the Chaos Gods are pouring in, scouring the path. Yeah, even worse, my Savage Floods are eventually receding. Yeah, so the Old World, we have survived the Chaos Hordes. Could we defeat the Everwatcher? Killed in battle. Bjorn Ironside, Lord of Var. Iber, I don't even know who this guy is. So we need a new lord. Who should we pick? Leadership aura in battle? I guess we'll take this guy. Summon me if you dare. Underway upgrade? Well, that's good. Mount Gundabad. Repairs are... Just means we get to move quicker underground, which is good because we've got Ungrim moving northwards. So, we can actually move a lot further. Yeah, we can actually move all the way up here, which is good. His army, yeah, he can actually go to Zufbar. That's good. Oh, that's such a sad thing we lost Bjorn. Bjorn fought bravely for so long. So long, and I just kind of threw his life away like it was nothing. Oh well, so I guess we send this army back now to get ready and start replenishing and building new units and stuff. Wait, who did I just move? Oh, I just moved out with Fane, didn't I? I'm an idiot. That's fine. Move Thorgrim back. Bjorn's remnants of this army can go back into Varric Hills. He can go back. This is the new lord of Varric. Oh, so annoying I played that battle so poorly. We'll keep on boosting up his range. I mean, I guess we should be doing this. Yeah, we should be doing that. That was my bad. Too early in the morning to play this. That's my excuse. No, there's no excuses for that battle. I really, really messed up. Don't think so. Cool. Cool. I think we're ready just to end the episode here. Oh no, what we want to do? Yeah. Oh, definitely. I don't know why I haven't done it already. Where's Forgrim? We want to build some gyrocopters in your army. We'll do that next turn so we can further one of his quests. I think it's the Nursey Axe, right? We need to have some. Oh no, not this one. The Axe of Grimnir. Yeah, we need to have two gyrocopters in our army. So we'll do that next turn. Cool. So this has been a 45-minute battle. Again, it was kind of a bad mess up on the battle. I definitely could have claimed victory there. I was just being a bit stupid. But I hope you guys don't mind. You know, it's all part of the story, all part of the journey, all part of the campaign. Obviously, I'm much, much better than that. You guys have seen me just wreck people. It's just because I've never really come up against a force that strong and that good in like forever. And I was kind of just half-assing it and being like, yeah, whatever. Like, because normally when I play large battles, I can normally just not really pay attention and still claim victory, not really have to do that much intensive micro. But I guess, you know, that kind of I paid the price for that. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed anyway. Make sure to drop a like and a comment if you did, and I'll see you guys next time and fish out. Oh yeah, next episode we're gonna have an epic battle. I'm gonna move Ungrim to fight all four of these armies, all five of these armies, and it's just gonna be fucking epic. I can't wait. So I even though they're actually suffering a lot of attrition, I guess there's just not enough chaos corruption or something. I don't know. Maybe we won't. Maybe we'll just take back Zufbar or something. But yeah, we'll decide that next episode. Maybe you guys can give us some suggestions in the comments. But yeah, I'll see you guys next time and fish out.